Hello and welcome to round 19 of the Liberty A-League, and after a few delays we are finally about to get underway between Melbourne City and the Newcastle Jets. And this evening's contest is between two sides trying to maintain their spot in the top six. And for Melbourne City, the last five games have proved to be a difficult period for the team, going winless, and they've been looking to break that drought tonight and get their footing back in the top six and maintain their position there. And for their opponents, the Newcastle Jets, it obviously hasn't been the smoothest sailing season, but they are in consistent form and they find themselves in the top six at the moment, and they are in a potential spot to make the finals for the first time since 2017-2018 season. They'll be looking to get the 3 points this afternoon, and it is also the Pride celebration. And you can see the Melbourne City players with their shirts and see some flags as well. As we'll take a look at the starting 11 for Melbourne City, and Dario Vidicic makes two changes to his starting 11. Kira Myers makes only her second start of the season, and Leah Davison also starts after coming on for an injured Leah Varley last week. And as always, Rebecca Stott anchors the defence, and fellow Kiwi Hannah Wilkinson leads the line. And for the Newcastle Jets, Ryan Campbell names an unchanged starting 11 from the side that drew with Perth last weekend. And as always, Serena Bolden leads the line alongside Mindy Barbieri, who got the equalising goal against Perth, alongside Lauren Allen. And Cass Davis anchors the midfield alongside Libby Copus-Brown. And there is Rebecca Stott, the captain of Melbourne City, and such an important player for them. She's such a good indicator. If City are feeling confident, they obviously love to press the ball up high and have them maintain a lot of possession. Rebecca Stott has the most passes in opposition half this season with 527. And if Melbourne City do have that high line, you know they're feeling really confident about their football, and they'll be looking for some more aggressive and attacking passes from her this afternoon. And there is Serena Bolden, the main woman for Newcastle Jets. 11 goals to her name this season. She could potentially get the golden boot if she's able to get a few more goals this afternoon and for the remainder of the season. But such an important player, and it'll be really difficult to stop her from Melbourne City. And there is Dario Vidicic. It's been a difficult season for his side. They started really well, but they've lost the likes of Holly McNamara throughout the season. Got a few players away with the young Matildas at the moment, and his side are just struggling with their form, and they'll be looking to maintain their spot in the top six this evening and just find a 3 points, which is something that's been hard to come by for his side. And our referee for this afternoon's contest, Caitlin Williams, she'll be hoping it'll be a nice, calm afternoon, and we will have some breaks throughout the first half and the second half, obviously with the heat this afternoon. And the away coach for the Newcastle Jets is Ryan Campbell. Since coming in, his side have managed to maintain a little bit of consistency, and they've been scoring, but they'll be hoping to find a little bit of consistent form. It'll be a tough battle against Melbourne City. Even though they haven't been getting the 3 points, they'll be feeling pretty confident that his side will be able to get the 3 points this afternoon and make the finals for his first time coaching this side. And there is Amina Rekic, such an important player for Melbourne City this season. Scored 6 goals so far. And you know she's a player that can create something out of absolutely nothing, and they'll like to get her on the ball. Melbourne City, the goals have just dried up recently, and that's a player who can certainly unlock a defence if she just gets a little bit of space and a little bit of time. Sophie Hoban for the Newcastle Jets, a nice young player and such a creative outlet for the Newcastle Jets. Got 2 assists to her name so far this season. Will be looking to get a few more and secure the 3 points for her side, but one of those crucial influential players for the Newcastle Jets this afternoon. And we're not too far away from getting underway at the City Football Academy down in Melbourne Southeast. Just waiting momentarily to get the all clear. And we are underway here. Melbourne City, get us going. Ball played out wide. Back into the middle. Need to be patient, Melbourne City, but need to be aggressive. Had a lot of possession throughout the season, a hallmark of their playing style, but the goals and just the ability to unlock other teams' defences, they've just really struggled with that, particularly since Holly McNamara has been away. And without Daniela Galic, who's away with the young Matildas, it's another thing they'll have to contend with this afternoon. Needs to be careful there, Taylor Rotto, and cleared away by Barbara. Newcastle trying to win the ball up high, but not able to do that. Otto. Treat back to Barbara, back out to Otto. Immediately that press from Newcastle. Sending it down the line, but intercepted by Davis. And tried to flick on pass Indy Barbieri, but didn't have it enough. Scored the equaliser. They had to wait a long time for it. Newcastle, they were probably the more dominant of the two sides against Perth last weekend and only managed to come away with the point, but really strong, positive performance. We're hoping that the more goals come their way this afternoon. Poor one by City. Now out to Myers. Forced to retreat and that ball's taken away. Tolosina. Now Davidson. Playing it out wide for Rosmarken and not able to get on the end of that. Okay, Rosmarken playing it back to Stott. Hounded by Bolden. Needs to make it. Clear decision, and that ball has gone out of play. Down the line, but headed out once again. Peters knocks it down. Allen tried to play it into the path of Bolden, not able to do so. Polisina not able to control it. Myers kept it in play, but wasn't to the advantage of her team. Bolden, nice pass forward, more so a nice idea, just couldn't get it to work in the end. Stott playing it into the middle of the park and not able to be controlled. And that's a strong challenge there by Amina Rekic. Not known for her defensive play, but left a little bit something there on Lorena Bauman. Swiss international, strong bump. Probably feeling that tomorrow. Of movement in the box. A nice ball and completely missed that header. Jetson, it was a great early opportunity for them, just couldn't get the contact. And dangerous ball out of the box, still not worked just yet by City. Nicely picked up and a strong collision in the middle of the park. Play continues. not able to trap the ball. Barbieri taken away from Hughes. Bolden, Copus Brown now. Copus Brown with a little bit of space and couldn't get the contact required. Brazilian international Barbara replacing Lissianne Prue, who went back to the NWSL. Really great get for Melbourne City. Polisina able to turn and just left it a little bit behind Carly Rosbach, and too much work for her to do. Karavitis down the line. Copus Brown. Rosbach now, not the direction she wants to be facing. Need to get out of this little pocket of trouble here, Melbourne City. They've been forced back a lot of times by the Jets. Ekic able to turn, but turn straight into trouble. Still Ekic, and City get away with that. They haven't made too much forward progress. You can see the pressure that the Jets want to deploy this afternoon. Don't want to give Melbourne City any time or space. Wilkinson out wide for Ekic. He sends it through, and Mariana Polisina does look offside, but play has continued, and Linesman has put up her flag. She did look well offside. Wilkinson sending it out wide to Ekic, and just couldn't get the ball under control. Barbieri. Ball sent across to Copus Brown, but wasn't able to control the ball. And sloppy pass from City, so Ward's the ball straight back, and now Allen certainly ambitious with that strike from that angle. May potentially have been the cross that didn't come off. Good men. Long ball from Barbara. Ekic there underneath the ball. But it will go out for a Jets throw in. Bauman. Pryor. Back to Izzy Nino. A ball not to the advantage of the Jets, but able to control it. Copus Brown. Ball knocked away by Davidson. Stott. Couldn't get that pass to Myers. Stott following up with the pass. Still Rebecca Stott, and Copus Brown takes it out of play. You can see Ryan Campbell giving instruction to his side, making sure they are in the right shape. Bolden, nice ball forward, but not able to be brought down by Hoban. Otto, need to play out quickly here, Melbourne City, just on the ball a little bit too long, allowing the Jets to get back into their shape. And that ball almost given away cheaply. And it is given away. Bolden. Davis. And too heavy with that pass. Ross Barkin. Got Myers charging up ahead. That ball just in between two City players, so had to stop the momentum slightly. Bowman down the line. Bolden just flicked it up high, gave herself a little bit of time. Up against Leah Davidson. And that ball will go out of play, so it will be a goal kick. Now how good Serena Bolden is. Able to finish in any way she likes. Such an impressive player, and it's really surprising that she didn't start the Liberty A-League season with the club. Came in for the Jets and has certainly done a job for them after Melina Ayres being out with injury. Hasn't been a player that has been able to be relied on by the Jets this season, unfortunately. Davis, Allen, and giving away to Polisina. He's just going to play it forward, but taken away by Bowman. Davis, who's that strong challenge? Myers tried to play it around from Karapetis, but Karapetis won that battle. Forced back to Nino. Hughes. Now Polisina does get a slight touch to it, but not able to push it far enough for Kira Myers. Nino, Pryor. And Kira Myers played with the FV emerging side in the Victorian MPL. The first season in the competition, but a really promising young player. Stott under pressure once again. It's been a hallmark of the game so far. Very dangerous play here by Melbourne City. Certainly playing with fire. Polisina able to get away from Davis, but immediately swarmed once again. Ross Barkin, Otto to Barbara. Can see the way City want to play, and they finally made their way out. Really nice bit of play in the box. Davidson now out wide. Got options up ahead. There is Briley Henry. Still with the strike, and Nino able to grab comfortably. Wants to get play going early. Riley Henry with that attempt was able to run a long way. Never really pressure, but just couldn't get the contact in the end. Ross Barkin. Hughes. Back to Hughes. Need to work their way through this traffic, Melbourne City. Every pathway seems to be blocked. This is exactly what the Newcastle Jets want. City going sideways and backwards. No forward progress really being made. Bowman didn't get it the first time and then pushed by Ekic. And free kick given away. Be an interesting battle between those two this afternoon. Gotten away through the traffic, the Jets. Bowman out wide for Hoban. Sending it across Hoban, but headed away by Stott. Otto with another head up. Into the path of Myers. She's done really well, but ran straight into Karapetis. But there is Wilkinson in support. Myers up against Tash Price. Still Kira Myers looking for teammates to help her out. Just sends it across. Ball deflects back in her path, but not able to bring it under control. Ross Barkin. Otto. Talia Davidson. Drifting into the midfield. It's Briley Henry. Quite deep, and we will have the first drinks break of the afternoon. We will have one every 15 minutes in this contest due to the weather in Melbourne. Not typical to have this much heat in March, Melbourne. Via energetic first half from the Newcastle Jets, putting a lot of pressure on Melbourne City, making it very difficult for them to make their way out of their own defence, and haven't had many attacking opportunities. That Briley Henry one was really their only one of the first half, and the Jets had that set piece and not able to get any clean contact on it. There is Sophie Hoven. Need to get some more attacking rhythm, Newcastle. They've been doing a lot really well with their pressing and making it very difficult for Melbourne City, but they haven't had a lot of possession so far in the game. And it's been difficult. And obviously with this heated, difficult game either way, but 3 points up for grab nearing the end of the season. Be so important for this Newcastle Jets team and the club to get back into the finals. Haven't been back there since 2017-18. So it will get play back underway very soon. Bauman to get us going. Polisina playing it forward for Ekic, but not able to get it. Hughes. Back to Ekic. Henry. Otto. All taken off. Riley Henry there and just knocked forward. Davis. Back to Bauman. Back to Cash Davis. Wilkinson needs to find a teammate, but immediately swarmed and doesn't have any time to make a decision. Play continues. No foul awarded by Caitlin Williams. Ekic swinging it out wide to Kira Myers. Finds herself one-on-one with Karapetis. Still Kira Myers going on the outside. Now back on the inside. And that ball's taken a deflection and will be a corner for Melbourne City, their first of the game. Young Kira Myers, a really good, promising player. Good bit of skill. So Karapetis the wrong way, and really good defensive work from Lauren Allen in the end to block the shot. Polisina to deliver. Deep ball. There's no light blue shirts there and falls all the way to the other side. Otto able to get it. Needs a teammate to find the pass to. Not on the same page as Laura Hughes. Copas Brown dancing with the ball. Finds Bauman. Sends it down the line, but there's no Jets players there waiting for that pass. Davidson, Henry, Otto. Barbara. Ekic. They've worked their way out of trouble once again. Melbourne City doing really well, but Lauren Allen with that defensive hustle. But that ball straight into the path of Melbourne City, but won back immediately, and Wilkinson just couldn't control that ball and knocks it out of play. Pryor. Davis. Bauman. Really nice bit of skill there from Sophie Hoban. Really well done, and that ball's played forward. Need to track back there, Hughes, and she does really well. There is Emma Dundas. Not able to get that pass initially. And Tash Pryor stepped up at the right moment, able to collect the pass, and now opposite centre back. Taylor Otto done the same. Myers, heavy first touch. Still Kira Myers. Wilkinson's gone offside. Out wide to Polisina. And Polisina didn't have any time or space to really make a decision. Hoban. Running into space. Needs to be stopped. Still Sophie Hoban. Barbieri ran into traffic. And the pass to follow up wasn't great either, and a strong challenge and a free kick awarded to City. Indy Barbieri, Torian, plays for Box Hill in the NPL. A really good creative player, left Adelaide in the off-season to go to Newcastle. Had some great moments, and that strong challenge there on Laura Hughes. Certainly been a physical contest at times. Dundas. Intercepted by Davidson. Tried to slip it through for Wilkinson, and that ball just stopped. And she outran it. Henry to Ekic. Switching play once again, Amina Ekic, and Myers couldn't get that first time pass. Stott playing it into the middle for Polisina, who just held off Cass Davis. Really nice bit of team play from Melbourne City, the little things. Wilkinson able to get the ball. Nino out of her box, able to keep it in play. Wilkinson and Nino going back for a second challenge, and it will be just a goal kick, but they get away with that, the Jets. Isabel Nino very brave to come out of her box, but lucky for her, Hannah Wilkinson's touch just dragged her way too wide of goal to really create anything, and that follow-up effort just allowed enough time for Nino to get back. Otto. Stott. Just inviting the pressure, Melbourne City, just to try and create some space for themselves, as Ekic has done really well to get away from the challenge, and the ball will be brought back for the free kick. What a great strength there, Amina Ekic. So Romina Ekić just getting held by Bauman. As I mentioned, a really important battle this afternoon. Swiss international up against Bosnia Herzegovina international in Romina Ekić, such a promising young player. Polisina to deliver the ball. High ball, giving opportunity to her teammates. It's headed on. Nino with the save on the line and cleared for good measure. Really needed there, Isabel Nino, to stop Hannah Wilkinson. A good piece of goalkeeping. That ball was high in the air, gave enough time. It's actually may have just come off the head of Pryor, then Wilkinson, and very awkward in the end, but cleared away. That's all that matters for the Jets. Bolden, Allen alongside her, asking for it back, immediately gets it, and won back by Polisina. No free kick, play continues. Back to Polisina, who just drives it forward and just asks Wilkinson to do a little bit too much in the end. And Serena Bolden still on the ground after that strong collision. Really strong collision, and felt that a lot there, Serena Bolden. Just take a look at that. Came right through the side of her, Rihanna Polisina, and then Bolden just bounced off the turf as well. Really awkward fall and quite painful, you'd imagine. Tough player, you'd imagine she's going to be fine, but would feel that a lot. Quite surprising there was a free kick wasn't awarded, but play continues, and imagine this is the second drinks break, not too far away from that 30 minute mark, so just take a little bit earlier. Melbourne City, Daria Vidasic's side of it stood the pressure most of the time that the Jets have been applying, and they've had the better of the chances so far in this first half, but hasn't been easy for either side. Imagine Ryan Campbell would just like a slight uptick in possession for his side. Been doing a lot of the chasing, and particularly in this heat, don't want to be doing that. You want to be dictating the pace as much as you possibly can. Here we go, Jets. Ball sent forward to Barbara. Just picks it up, and dangerous throw, but quite confident in her own ability, obviously. So much experience. Hughes. One back. And it will be a free kick awarded. And the yellow card for Lorena Bauman. So that adds a little wrinkle to this game up against Ekić. And it's just a late, late foot there on Taylor Otto. And now Lorena Bauman's going to need to be careful up against the Amina Ekić, who you've already seen a few times in this contest get a little bit physical between those two. Imagine maybe Melbourne City go back to Ekić a little bit more. Not that they need more invitation to. She's such a great player. That ball given away cheaply to the Jets. Nino to Pryor. Hounded by Hughes. Copus Brown Haven't seen too much of her. Bauman. Down the line to Hoban. Seeing what she can do a few times, Hoban. Showing a little bit of skill. And not able to find the pass to feed through. Out wide now to Barbieri. Needs a good delivery and off the body there of Carly Rosbucken. So it will be a corner for the Jets. Gentleman with the smell shirt. Not a great sitting position if you're trying to watch the football, I would have to argue. As referee Caitlin Williams just gives a few more instructions to the players. Barbieri, nice ball in, headed down, and then the follow-up effort. Still bobbling around the box. No one's got clear contact. Pryor tried to get ahead to it. Needs to be just booted away by City. Not a great touch there by Lauren Allen. Ekic chipping it forward. And to no one in particular. Davis out wide to Barbieri. Wants to send it straight across. Barbieri. Just cleared away by Hughes. Myers, one-on-one with Karapetis again, and Karapetis stood up tall. Barbieri. And look at that once again. Really chaotic in the box. Could have been a few fouls called. Sent long to the path of Wilkinson. Plays it into the path of Polisina. Waiting for some more runners. Sends it to Myers. Looking for options. Kira Myers forced to retreat back. Rosbucken. Otto. Stott just sending it forward for Wilkinson to chase. There is Hannah Wilkinson up against Tash Pryor. Looking for some teammates in support. Has to go alone here, Hannah Wilkinson. Wilkinson cutting back on the inside. Plays it through. Myers. And there is the goal for young Kira Myers. Breaking the deadlock, Melbourne City. Very chaotic in the end. But it doesn't matter how it goes in. A fantastic goal. Well worked by the team. And that is a really good bit of play, and the first ever Liberty A-League goal for Kira Myers as well, and a nice way to get it, being a little bit influential in this game, and just tapped it past Isabel Nino. Calmly done. Nino went one way, the ball went the other. Really nicely done by Hannah Wilkinson to create that opportunity. Held the ball up, waited for some teammates to get in the box, but a first goal in the Liberty A-League in her first season for Kira Myers. A great moment for her. And that's something that they really lacked, Melbourne City. Is goal scoring threat. That ball's nicely played through for Hannah Wilkinson. It just knocks it forward. Pryor right up beside her. And Karapetis has done well, but Wilkinson's done even better. Cash Davis has to come back, do the defensive duties. Sent long by Nino to Bolden. Up against Rebecca Stott. Out wide to Allen. Barbieri tried to slip it through for Lauren Allen, not able to do so. Barbara. Strong play here from City, but one back by the Jets. Dundas to Bolden. Back to Copas Brown. Sending it wide and too much on the pass, and not able to be collected by Lauren Allen. And see here the instruction from Ryan Campbell for Libby Copas Brown. A player who can create something for this team. Got a really good connection with Serena Bolden and the attack. And she's been aggressive. It's a really great sign and indicator of the confidence in the Newcastle Jets team. Dundas. One by Ekic. Slipped through, but behind Wilkinson, so she wasn't able to get it. Ekic. It's done well. Back to Briley Henry. Playing in a defensive position tonight. Not typically what we see from Briley Henry. She is an attacker by trade. That ball given away cheaply to Myers, but doesn't have any teammates in support, so needs to hold up play. And just lost the ball out of play and ran out of space. And got her boot stepped on along the way as well. Barbieri, high. Pryor. Knocks it, but doesn't get it very far. Hughes to Otto. And taken away by Hoban. Ross Barkin forced to send it back to her keeper. And you just wonder for the Newcastle Jets. We'll come back to that as Lauren Allen wins it in a really great area, but not able to do anything with it, the Jets. How long they're going to be able to do this of pressing Melbourne City, this intensity, to work rate. You can already see it just starting to fade a little bit as the half has gone on. In this heat, will they be able to do it? Will they need to find a new game plan? Find a new route to goal. Copas Brown. Back to Karafidis. Nino. Barbieri. Copas Brown, gonna play it through for Bolden, a beautiful pass forward. Serena Bolden coming through, Bolden hits the crossbar. And that pass deserved a goal, really nicely done. Took it really well, Bolden, and just hit the crossbar, the closest you can get. And Copas Brown, spoke to you about how important she is as a player. Briley Henry did her best to apply pressure, and I think you've got to give her credit for forcing that strike a little bit high and off balance from Serena Bolden. Pryor. Hoban. Sending it across. Otto. just been a little bit reckless here. Melbourne City playing out from the back. Copus Brown looking for Bolden immediately. Bolden tried a little adventurous back. And that effort once again from Dundas, wide of goal. Really positive opening 45 for Melbourne City, but when you see chances like that for Serena Bolden, you know there is always that threat, that follow-up effort from Dundas, just wide of goal. Gotta be smarter with those passes from Hughes, a little bit sloppy, straight into the path of a Jets player's boot. And that ball's played forward for Ekic. Got Wilkinson charging through the middle. Ekic cuts inside. Amina Rekic with the effort. Sailing over the bar. But that's what she wants. She wants to cut back on the inside. She wants that little bit of space. Getting loose this game as the half goes on. A lot of effort, a lot of energy being used in the first 45. Amina Rekic lost Bauman, and that follow-up effort just couldn't keep it down. And Goldwood, that ball played forward. It's the path of Copus Brown, but Stott just watches it as it goes safely into the hands of Barbara. Hoban, taken away there by Davidson. Immediately won back by Sophie Hoban. Copus Brown. And not on the same page there, Barbieri and Carapias. Not long left in this opening 45 here at the City Football Academy. Sun is, looks like it's finally starting to set just a little bit. That ball fall for Wilkinson up against Pryor. Need to be clever to get away, but uses Myers, who's in support. Still Kira Myers, and just once again, not on the same page as Hannah Wilkinson, but goes back to do that little bit of defensive work, slowing the play down, giving time for her team to get back into defensive structure. Myers with the header. Tried to play it into space, gets a boot to it. Pryor. Copus Brown taken away by Hughes. Davidson, now Wilkinson, just playing it out wide for Rekic. Looked like she might have been slightly offside. Still Amina Rekic on the inside. Amina Rekic just wide of goal. Two really good chances for Rekic in the last few minutes. Big warning signs for the Newcastle Jets. Need to be very careful. And with Lorena Bauman on a yellow card, can be slightly limited as we see that chance once again. Bauman slipped, but Ekic just for a moment lost the ball. And we do see a player down on the far side, and it is Briley Henry. Just rubbing her face and maybe got hit in the face. We'll try and get another look at that. Briley Henry with that defensive stop on Serena Bolden just put her off momentarily as she took that strike. Not typically, as I've mentioned, not typically a defender. Attacker by trade, and there will be 5 minutes of added time in this first 45 minutes of football between Melbourne City and the Newcastle Jets. Akira Myers' goals that separates the two sides. Really big 3 points up for grabs. Melbourne City trying to stay in touch with the top two. Looking to regain some ground after they've just been slipping on the table in recent weeks as the wins have not been coming their way. And for Newcastle, it's a really important 3 points up for grabs. Don't want to give any chance to Western Sydney Wanderers, Perth Glory and even Wellington, who are a little bit further back. That race for the top six, it's really on, and some teams that we thought started the season really well have fallen away, where some teams have found their form late on. It's the benefit of a longer Liberty A-League season as we see Hobart making her way forward, sending it across and not able to be controlled by Barbieri or Bolden. Henry back to Otto. Can imagine Melbourne City will look to slow the game down, get to half time with this 1-0 lead. Barbara with a heavy touch invited the pressure for Barbieri, but one back by the Jets. Karapetis. Karapetis under pressure from Kieran Myers. Copus Brown giving away cheaply to Davidson, who is being held back, and a free kick will be awarded. Take a look at that again, and Copus Brown, it was very tactical foul. She knows she was beat, but wouldn't want to give here Davidson any time or space to make her way forward and make that decisive pass. Dundas, Bolden, heavy touch, straight into the path of Hughes. Hughes with that ball forward. Ekic trying to keep it in play. Able to do so. Still Amina Rekic up against Bauman, beats her. Still Ekic needs to drag it back across. And Nino with the good piece of goalkeeping. Could Ekic have passed that ball potentially a little bit earlier? Had Wilkinson waiting for the ball. Ross Barkin under pressure from Barbieri. Hughes, see, she's gone with the no sleeves option, something we typically see Taylor Otto do. When not doing that a lot today. It is a great game for a tan. Always wear sunscreen though, very important. There's a ball. Nutmeg there from Myers on Karapetis, and free kick will be awarded. Really good 45 minutes for Kieran Myers in only her second ever start in the Liberty A-League. And to get a goal as well, very, very impressive. If you've seen her in the Victorian NPL, Charlotte Southern United, and then quickly got the move to FV Emerging. Stott out wide to Henry. Ekic. And a nice little nutmeg from Amina Rekic. No penalty awarded. Play continues. But the question is, if it wasn't a penalty, could it have been a dive? Bolden forced very deep to get the ball. It's not the position she'd like to receive it, and it will be a free kick. So take a look at this again. Amina Rekic did really well to beat Sophie Hoban. Cheeky little nutmeg, and gotta wonder, there wasn't too much contact there from Hoban on Ekic. She went down pretty softly, so gotta wonder why no card was shown to her. Not long left in this first 45, and Tash Pryor having a few words with lineswoman there. Shouldn't be too much longer with this stoppage. played forward. And that is half time here at City Football Academy. Melbourne City have the 1-0 lead, courtesy of Akira Meyer's goal. Her first ever goal in the Liberty A-League. It was really dominant half, you'd have to say, from Melbourne City. The Jets were doing some good defensive work, trying to stop the efforts there of Melbourne City, as we saw Carly Rosbach, and just have a few words with the referee. But at half time, it is Melbourne City 1, Newcastle Jets 0. And we'll take a look at the first half chances as that ball's played forward for Hannah Wilkinson. And this was the goal. She did well, she was patient, drove forward, and tried to play it through for Polisina and Davidson. And there was Kira Myers right at the back. Tap it straight past Isabel Nino. Confident finish. Nino went one way, Myers went the other, in a reserved celebration, but a really great moment for her. And we take a look at this pass from Libby Copus Brown. A fantastic ball into the path of Serena Bolden, who was just knocked off her path by Briley Henry. But a great opportunity for Bolden to potentially have leveled up the game. And it was the best opportunity, you'd have to say, the Jets had in the first half. And that's something that Serena Bolden should feel like she could have potentially done a little bit better. But a strong finish, strong chance for the Jets there. As we take a look at the halftime stats, and can see that's more shots for Melbourne City. And they've had more shots on target. The Jets have just been a little bit reserved in their attacking opportunities, but it is Melbourne City 1-0 up at half time, and we'll be back for more action in the second half.
You have to do this to that. back to the side, onto the field for the second half.
And welcome back for the second half between Melbourne City and the Newcastle Jets. I'm just going to make a quick clarification. Did look that Melbourne City at halftime were up 1-0, courtesy of Akira Meyer's goal. But as we'll have a look. The goal was ruled offside. As we'll take a look here, if you just look at the linesman on the far side, as play continues with Wilkinson. And Myers had just drifted offside, it seems, and it did look like players was going about to restart. All the players lined up in the middle, and referee got called over to the lineswoman, gave her the signal that it was offside. You can see the referee just on the far side of your screen running over to the linesman on the side, having a quick discussion. And that's where you can see Melbourne City players going all the way back to the other side. Everybody's thinking it's a goal for City, but it is still nil all. And right there, as the decision is made and we have to go back, and the ball. So it is nil nil here at City Football Academy. So still all to play for. All the work to be done by Melbourne City. They certainly were in the ascendancy at the end of the first half. A couple of chances for Amina Rekic-Bolden. Barbara. Copas Brown chipping it through for Bolden, but not able to get it to dip in time. Barbara. Otto. Henry. Hughes. Davidson, and not able to be controlled by Myers. Hughes, and a free kick is awarded to the Jets. So, if you are the Newcastle Jets and a Newcastle Jets fan, you'll be pretty confident now. And after withstanding all the pressure from Melbourne City in the first half and having their goal scratched off, you'll feel that with the chance that Bolden had as that ball, high ball, Otto able to head it away, that you as the side will be able to come back into this contest and get the lead for themselves. Bauman. Bolden flicks the header on. Copas Brown and just misjudges the ball slightly. Henry worked her way through traffic nicely. Still Briley Henry sends it back and back all the way to Serena Bolden. Got Lauren Allen in support. Stott forces her back and wide. Allen, still Lauren Allen. Now Serena Bolden, little bit of space for Bolden. Barbieri. Doesn't take the strike. Davis. Davis now with the long range effort. And that was always sailing over the crossbar. Tash Davis doesn't have too many goals to her name, but somebody you wouldn't want to give a chance to. She can't hit it. Davidson out wide for Ekic. Really nicely done. Ekic with a little bit of space. Bauman closely shadowing her. Feeding it through for Briley Henry. Evades the tackle. Across goes Briley Henry. Davis needs to get out of the penalty box. Does. Held up nicely by Ross Barkin. And it will be a throw-in for Melbourne City. Take a look at Amina Rekic's pass to Henry. A really nice play from her, but just couldn't get that follow-up ball into the box. Done. Otto sends it all the way back to her keeper. Hughes, back to Hughes. Caught, trying to make a decision and has to evade the pressure of Lorena Bauman. Hughes once again. Davidson, slipping that ball through and finds Briley Henry. Got Wilkinson in the middle. Now Hannah Wilkinson, does make it 1-0 for Melbourne City. And that is why you have Briley Henry there, an attacking-minded player, feeding it through to Hannah Wilkinson, and easy as you like. Melbourne City, they restore that phantom 1-0 lead. And now they do have the lead in this contest. They've been the more attacking of the two sides, and once that ball found Briley Henry, you knew where it was going, and Hannah Wilkinson was not going to miss from there. A fantastically worked goal from City. And now all to do for the Newcastle Jets. Wouldn't have wanted to concede that early in the second half. So now all the pressure on them to come back in this game. And really nicely done by City, not getting their momentum waved and their confidence rocked after that goal was waved off in the first half. Barbara, under pressure, sends it across to Stott, who's also under pressure. Henry, and not able to control it, and does go out of play. And Melbourne City, as you would expect, 59% possession to the 41 for the Newcastle Jets. It's the hallmark of their game. Dictating the play as that ball almost falls for Barbieri. Had to quickly recover, City. And there is two balls on the field, so we will re-throw the throw in. And maybe a City fan just trying to do a little bit too much to help the team. Bauman sends it into the box. Headed goalward. Barbara just showing that Brazilian flair, just chesting it, and just a singular juggle as well. Barbara sending it forward. Couldn't find a teammate. Hughes, and got two players down in the middle of the park. Cass Davis and, sorry, it's Mindy Barbieri and Rihanna. Well, it's in it, no. Correction, it's Leah Davidson. Strong challenge in the middle. And that's certainly going to hurt. Javieri came flying in and then caught Davidson, and either of them coming off well. Take a moment to recompose themselves and Barbieri just has to go off as well as Davidson just to then quickly make their way back onto the field. Stott, send it across dangerously to Otto. Finds Hughes, who was immediately fouled. Let's get play underway once again. Davidson. Hughes to Davidson. Hoban. Hoban finds that pass, and then Barbie at Henry. Challenge in the end, and it will be throw in, and Emma Dundas with a yellow card for the Newcastle Jets as Barbieri sends it into the box. No one's able to get ahead to it as Barbara is a long way out of her goal. Kira Mai certainly dragged back there by Karapetis. Davidson. That ball played forward for Briley Henry. Wilkinson once again in the middle of the box, sends it across. Wilkinson, easy as you like, tap in. And almost like a replay, Briley Henry to Hannah Wilkinson has made a strong connection this afternoon. And they're two goals to the good, Melbourne City. And another easy finish for Hannah Wilkinson. Briley Henry found herself in a nice little bit of space. Knew exactly once again where it was going. Just had to play that pass into the path of Hannah Wilkinson and just slotted it away. A really good performance from Briley Henry this afternoon. Not doing something she typically does, but getting forward, getting involved as well. And Hannah Wilkinson, two goals to her name. And she's on a hat trick now. You know she'd certainly love that as a striker. Otto. If it was a tough battle for Newcastle after one goal, it's going to be even more difficult with the second. But they do have the players capable of getting themselves back into this contest. 2-0 lead is a dangerous one in football. One goal back and everybody starts getting a little bit more stressed as that ball's dangerously played across the face of the box. Wilkinson. There is another thing that's so indicative of Melbourne City, an 80% passing accuracy. So we see Ross Barkin charging forward, isn't able to finish off with the pass. Now finds Wilkinson. And first touch dragged her a little bit wide, but still found a teammate in Myers. Davidson sending it to the feet of Ekic. Now Briley Henry. Forced to retreat, but this is some of the best football Melbourne City have played in a long while. Looking very fluid Polisina, nice touch. Dragged a little bit wide, but still in possession. Sending it wide to Rosbarkin. Now Myers. Hughes. Rosbarkin to Polisina. Got options in the middle, but under pressure from Davis. Still Polisina tries the nutmeg. May just work out for Melbourne City, and it does. Myers able to recycle the ball. His consistent pressure is what Melbourne City are after. Dictate the play. Shift and manipulate the Newcastle structure. Find another entry pass. Get a third goal and really seal it off. An untimely slip there for Henry. Makes it work. Wilkinson. Davidson. Otto. And so eight total shots to Newcastle's five. Consistent pressure and the quality of chances for Melbourne City have been there. Four on target, two goals to the good. Positive afternoon. What would make it probably better as Kieran Myers get that goal back. First ever goal in the Liberty A-League. Davidson slipping that ball through for Briley Henry once again. Can they do it a third time? Can't get the pass to go. But that really looks like an option that's there for Melbourne City every single time they want that ball over the top to Briley Henry to feed it back across to Wilkinson. And the win this afternoon, if they're able to hold on, Melbourne City will get them back into second spot. Get him a first week bye, but still a lot of football to be played. Barbieri slipping it across to Bolden, and a really timely dive across by Rebecca Stott. Now can they make their way forward once again? Myers, Rapidus shadowing her, and it will be a throw in for Melbourne City. Difficult afternoon for the youngster, and we will have our first drinks break of the second half. Take a look at that pass from Leah Davidson to Briley Henry, and easy as you like, Hannah Wilkinson, like a striker does, finishes the chances she gets. The movement from Henry, drawing the defender and then passing it across, a calm finish. And a strong celebration, and then this was the second one. Henry to Wilkinson. Easy as you like. Wilkinson had to stretch forward a little bit, but it doesn't really matter so long as it ends up in the back of the net. It was a calm pass from Briley Henry. Didn't rush it, didn't need to. So long as it was in the path of Hannah Wilkinson, you knew she was going to finish it. Here is Taylor Otto talking to young defensive apprentice today, Briley Henry. And it is 2-0 in this contest. That first half goal to Kira Myers was waved away for an offside. Very, very late call there. Everybody was lined up at the halfway line. Looked like play had gone away normally, but that goal had been waved away for the first ever goal of Kira Myers. That's quite unfortunate for her, but for her side this afternoon, they are still 2-0 up, playing some really positive football. And we are seeing Letitia McKenna make her way on for Kira Myers, so the youngster won't get an opportunity to try and get an official first goal in the competition, and an experienced player like Letitia McKenna in the middle of the park. Really smart decision making, but even though that goal didn't stand for Kieran Myers, it was positive. First 45 minutes of football, got involved. Only her second ever start in the competition. Davidson able to control it, sends it across to McKenna, not able to control the ball, control the pass. Out to Henry. Hughes chipping it forward, but intercepted by Hoban. And there is Letitia McKenna to find a little bit of pressure. Melbourne City, 304 passes, accurate passes to Newcastle's 157. That is a clear sign of dominating, dictating the play. Newcastle have really struggled at times this afternoon to be fluid in their movement, attacking-wise. Their pressing has been nice, but Melbourne City, as a side who typically like to draw the other team in, experienced and have been able to work their way through the traffic, through the press. They need to do it one more time. Now, Wilkinson came short to receive the ball, but taken away by Pryor. Bauman sent back inside, and there were sky blue shirts there and light blue shirts. It's not Sydney FC. Zekic just went a little bit too early. Flipped on by Polisena, but straight into the path of Karapinas. Bolden, not able to control it. Ball will go out for a throw-in. Davidson. Otto. Henry sending it back to Stott. Polisena slipping it through, but couldn't find a teammate to receive the pass. Bolden just tried to play it to get one of her teammates to run onto it, and that pass is sent to Barbara, but Barbieri was chasing closely. Nicely read by Leah Davidson. But there was Cass Davis in that number six role. Make sure she couldn't make any more inroads forward. Ekic. Making her way inside. Still Amina Ekic. Davidson saw the pass was a little bit too heavy. Came to support her teammate. Barbieri came back. Took some defensive work, but Melbourne City still retained possession. Otto inviting the pressure. Henry forced to go back, all the way back to Barbara. Nicely done to Polisena. Just bumped slightly by Bauman. We'll see another substitution. As we'll see, Shelby McCran come on for Leah Davidson. Bauman. Bolden. Dundas not able to bring the ball under her control. Bauman sending it across. Headed goalward by Lauren Allen, but calmly controlled, and there is Barbara, not afraid to just send it long sometimes. Seeing it part of Melbourne City's play a lot early in the season was always to go short, but sometimes you just got to send it long and clear away the pressure. May work to Melbourne City's favour anyway. Henry. Mann. McKenna. Wilkinson. Stott. Sent out wide for McKenna. What can she deliver? Know what Briley Henry's been able to do from this right-hand side. Polisina, nice pass inside. Still Polisina. Now Briley Henry just lost control. McMahon with the long-range effort just wide of the post. A really good effort from the substitute. Just wide of goal with a lot of traffic in her way. With those two goals today, Hannah Wilkinson's on 8, outright leader for Melbourne City this season in goals scored. Had a few players stuck on 6. Okay, took a look at that effort again from Shelby McMahon. Some shouts for handball, but referee Caitlin Williams doesn't agree. Copas Brown, haven't seen much of her in this second half. When Newcastle were in the ascendancy in the first half, she was getting on the ball a lot. Hoban leaving it for Barbieri, sends it across. Barbieri and Bolden with the header. Over the crossbar, came at her very quickly, just couldn't send it downwards. Just gotta say, Barbara is maybe one of the most techie players on the field, just casually bringing out its skill here and there for a goalkeeper. That's what you're after, just the bonus points, as we are gonna see another substitution, this time for the Newcastle Jets, as Emma Dundas, we've seen the last of her this afternoon, and number 24, Milan Hammond, is gonna be brought on to see what she can do. Can she change this game for Newcastle? Brave bit of play by Shelby McMahon. Just couldn't get the pass weighted correctly. Allen sending it across. Start heading it away, but only into the path of Hoban, who's immediately sent down. Barbieri now. All into the box. Got some options. Hoban bringing it down. Hoban with the effort, always off balance. And there is, I believe, Mindy Barbieri in the box as well, just calling for some medical attention, and that effort from Sophie Hoban. Always going wide of goal. Hopefully Mindy Barbieri's okay. Just needs to probably just take a moment after that collision. Just slight collision in the box there with her and Briley Henry. And see, just in the background, Laura Hughes and Barbara chatting, figuring out what they want to do. Melbourne City still want to be aggressive and to take a look at that challenge once again, and just an awkward fall. Mary once again got to go off to come back on. There isn't much time left in this contest for the Newcastle Jets if they want to get a result. Barbieri scored in the 77th minute last week. We need a goal around the same time. At least the first goal, you'd like it to be the second. Barbara back across to Otto. Henry McKenna. Back to Otto. Barbara Bolden. Right up against it. Bauman. One back by McKenna. And there's an untimely slip from Barbara. And probably made the smarter decision just to let it go out for a corner, as opposed to touching it and giving Serena Bolden any chance of getting the ball. After that, now you need to defend this corner. And there is Bolden, ended up on the floor somehow. Just feels like a regular routine of a corner. Referee Caitlin Williams gonna have a couple of chats, give some instructions. No pushing, no shoving. Let's have a clean game. Good vibes all round. Barbara's back. See if anybody falls this time. Barbieri, high, deep delivery. Do get ahead to it, wide of goal. Tash Pryor. Just Barbara with a strong shove there and a little bit of a ballast dive there from Serena Bolden. I reckon she's pretty strong. I don't know if she falls that easily, but a strong push nonetheless. Polisina, can they make their way out? That ball slipping through, and it's Melnino able to clear it away, but straight into the path of Stott. Barbara to Otto. See, the press is really intensified here from Newcastle. Now the game is on the line, but it certainly opened things up a little bit more here, as that pass is just a little bit too early for Hannah Wilkinson. But Letitia McKenna is not going to give up on the play. Sends it across to Polisina. Polisina has to dig it out from her feet. It was always going to be tricky going for it like that. High ball from Nino forward as Bolden tries to improvise with the header. Hammond. Man, right next to her. Now Briley Henry. And as she's done all afternoon, she's done her job really well and done the extras as well. Tisha McKenna, why you like a player like her? Doesn't give up on the play. And that was really difficult chance for Polisina. Needed to be better with the first touch. Barbieri sending across. Barbara palms it away. Copus Brown with the follow-up effort. And it will be a goal kick this time. Indy Barbieri still can't believe it's a goal kick, not a corner. We'll take a look. Barbara knocking it away. Copus Brown quick with the effort and may have actually come off a teammate on the ground, has made its way out. So, second drinks break. And the last one of the second half. So, a final opportunity for Ryan Campbell to really deliver his message to his team. Give them the keys to unlock this Melbourne City defense. And this is what Melbourne City did to unlock the Newcastle defense, as Briley Henry, quick and easy pass across to Hannah Wilkinson for the second goal. A calm finish, an excellent pass across, and it's exactly what they're after, Melbourne City. The goals have been really hard to come by in recent weeks, but they've been consistent. I'd even say they've been super duper, as they enjoy those in those drinks breaks, and probably a benefit of the drinks break. Everybody enjoys a super duper. Personally, a cola flavor individual myself. Thank you. Riley Henry, a really strong performance from her this afternoon. First time she's really seeing her in this position, and really strong performance. Allen. Wilkinson able to avoid that challenge. Still Wilkinson tried to slip it through for Rekic and just wasn't on the same page, those two. Davis, Allen, back to Davis. Need to be quick and sharp here, Newcastle. Need to be decisive if they want to get anything out of this game. McKenna to Wilkinson, out wide to Ekic. Melbourne City, much they've done throughout this game. Team possession, dictate the way game has been played. 61% possession today. Wilkinson not able to chase that ball down. Rubin up against McMahon, who wins that battle. McKenna tried to nutmeg Bauman. Still McKenna slipping it through. Wilkinson not able to get on the end of it. McMahon, once again, a really great young player. Another one is Polisina, slipped through. Rihanna Polisina, not able to finish. A good save from Isabel Nino, but you've got to ask, should Rihanna Polisina have done a little bit better? That certainly would have wrapped the game up, but benefit of a two-goal buffer. Doesn't matter as much when you miss some chances, but Isabel Nino did really well to block the angle to the near post for Polisina. Take a look at that. Sheldon McMahon, a great pass through. And Polisina tried to go near post, and Nino alert to a chance. Out wide now to Ekic. Sent it across and off the feet of Karapetis, so it will be a throw-in. They haven't won a game, Melbourne City, since they won 2-1 against the Nuke, against Wellington Phoenix back in January. It's been a long, long wait for the last 3 points. They've been slipping on the table. So if they are able to hold on, which you'd imagine they do so, be a really important 3 points. Keep them in that hunt for the top two spots. Avoid having to play the first week of finals. Otto. Good play from the defender. It's exactly what they want from Taylor Otto. It's exactly why Daria Vidicic brought her in. Ball playing centre back. As we see Josie Allen going to make her way on. And we've seen the last of Lauren Allen. Quite a muted performance from Allen this afternoon. Hasn't really found the space that she typically likes. As Wilkinson, still Hannah Wilkinson, not giving up on that battle with Pryor, but not able to win out in the end. But they do get a throw in. It is Allen for Allen, but different Allens. Polisena. She's done well, really well. Rihanna Polisena sends it across. McKenna unable to bring it down. It would have been a difficult chance to finish, but Rihanna Polisena, that's what the futsal skills come into play. Tight spaces, able to maneuver herself. Even if the goal's out there, Rihanna Polisena, such an important player for Melbourne City, so creative, such an engine, really nicely done, but it was always going to be a tricky finish for Letitia McKenna. Nino. McKenna. Hughes back to Wilkinson. Now McKenna out wide to Henry. Polisena, short option if she likes. Ignores her and to no one in particular in the end. But it may just come back. Stott. Sent long. McKenna, Hughes alongside her. Now McMahon. And really nicely left. Back to Ekic. Still Ekic needs a teammate in support. Ross Barkin is there, uses her. Back to Ekic. Needs to send it through and the flag has gone up, this time nice and early. Hoban. Hughes. A little bit of space here for City. Stott high up the field. Okay, good. Polisena, really nicely done from Rihanna Polisena. And that strike safely into the gloves of Isabel Nino. Has to play quickly here in order to give Newcastle a chance. But they need to get a move on. They do not have any time to spare. Allen sending it across, but there's no one there to be on the end of the pass. Bauman. Copus Brown, a very quiet second half. Saw that feed through to Serena Bolden in the first half. Haven't seen anything like that in the second. Bolden has been relatively quiet. Besides that header over the bar, haven't seen too many individual moments from her. Bauman, Davis, Allen, good defensive work there from Briley Henry. And we'll see another substitution. I was going to say, there is Alex Hunt making her way on for Sophie Hoban. And Josie Wilson also made her way on. We'll just see who Josie Wilson's come on for. Bauman. And that throw in will be retaken this time for Melbourne City. Thank you. Oh, yeah, I've got it. And... and we've seen the last of Emma Dundas this afternoon as well. McKenna tried to slip it through for Polisina. Connection wasn't there this time. Nino pressing up really high. Got to force the issue, Newcastle. No time to spare. Allen. Otto got a hand, a ball, a foot to it, sorry. Never looks under pressure there, Barbara. One of the most relaxed footballers out there. Ekic, not able to bring the ball under her control. Davis. A free kick, and it'll be 7 minutes added on. 7 minutes for Newcastle to create something, to do something unlikely. May not be the 3 points they can get, but one would certainly be crucial in their quest to make the six. McKenna sending it across. No shirts. They've done the Melbourne City crest, are able to get there on time. You can imagine Melbourne City are going to take their sweet, sweet time. Mindy Barbieri having a few words for Amina Rekic and Rihanna Polisina as they take a casual stroll. It's on the ball. There is 7 minutes, so... that ball's played short. Slipping it through for Rekic. Really nicely done. Amina Rekic, still Ekic. Dancing around maybe a little bit too long. Wilkinson with the effort. Looked like it came off the hand of Nina. Off the post and then out of play. Very surprising that a corner wasn't awarded. So close to her hat-trick. Allen, Davis, Sean McMahon is just going to calmly watch it and then just send it forward, but keep it in play, straight to Bauman. See the camera crew getting involved as well, going to show off a few touches. Bauman. Wilson, Pryor, now out wide to Allen. Needs to send it in quickly, and once again, there is Briley Henry. A strong afternoon for her, a strong challenge, and two assists to her name as well. Was never going to allow Josie Allen to get past her. So take a look at that. Just put shoulder to shoulder. Strong, strong challenge. Barbara sending it forward. Bauman. Surveying the options. Can't find a teammate that can do anything with it. Otto now. Confident play forward for Melbourne City. It's exactly where they want the ball. Letitia McKenna making her way through. That pass maybe just needed a little bit more from Wilkinson. As looks like it potentially could have come off an arm, but they'll only get a corner. That will work as well for Melbourne City. Would have preferred the penalty, you'd imagine, as Tisha McKenna sends it across. And just wasn't really the result thereafter. Penalty certainly would have sealed the game if it isn't already. Polisina to Henry. Briley Henry in a strong challenge in the box to prevent any opportunity. Now Serena Bolden for the Jets. Need to be quick here. Tash Pryor, center back, sending it out wide. What can this delivery be? Needs to be good. Milan Hammond sending it in finally. Took way too long, allowed too many Melbourne City players to get in the box. Cass Davis, Mindy Barbieri now. Teeing it up and easily headed away. Wilkinson. McMahon. Shelby McMahon, such an impressive player. Really nicely done. Barbieri. What can she do? No, she's got the quality. Sending it out wide. Milan Hammond now. Need to be quick with this delivery in the box. Too much just dancing around with the ball. Finally gets the delivery in. Bolden not able to get the clean touch that she needs. Knocked away by Polisina. Bauman. Sending it in, headed away once again. These are not the deliveries that the Newcastle Jets need. Needs to be quick, but it also needs to be precise to the advantage of teammates. Just haven't seen that quality many times throughout this game. And now, opportunity to seal it here for Melbourne City, sliding it across and straight to the feet of Bauman. Going back the other way. Otto. Stott. This extra time has been handled really well by Melbourne City. Have limited the quality of chances for Newcastle. Had some opportunities themselves. See. Clubs there. Not gonna rush to give the ball to Briley Henry. Barbieri able to keep it in play. Sending it forward. Barbara out of her box. Clears it away. Smart play. Taken away by Stott. Hughes. Wilkinson calling for it. You know she'd love to get a hat trick after all the work this afternoon. McMahon still looking to go goalward, but taken away by Tash Pryor. Got Josie Allen and Serena Bolden up ahead of her. Still Pryor driving forward, sending it out wide to Barbieri. Got Josie Allen in the middle. Across back to Pryor. Pryor now with the long-range effort, took a deflection, and Barbara calmly collects. Just take her time. And that is full-time here at the City Football Academy. Melbourne City coming away 2-0 winners, courtesy of two Hannah Wilkinson goals. And a really nice delivery into the box from Briley Henry. Some great performances all round from Melbourne City. They were after the 3 points this afternoon, but they also got a great performance as well as a team. A really strong, confident spruce that they need, particularly as we get into finals and near the end of the regular season. Dario Vidicic would certainly be a happy man. Charlotte McMahon came on, did a really good performance when she came onto the pitch. That's another one of those promising youngsters for Melbourne City. Few of them are away with the young Matildas, but then you still see the players they've got available. Really fantastic. And a great afternoon of football. But it finishes Melbourne City 2, Newcastle Jets 0. And this was the first goal. Leah Davidson, a really nice pass, and then once Hoban missed it, Briley Henry, all she had to do was tee up Hannah Wilkinson, took a touch, and then slotted it away. After that first half goal was ruled offside, they needed this early in the second half, and Hannah Wilkinson wasn't going to miss, and a strong reaction you could see from all the players. It meant so much, and then it was like deja vu again. Henry to Wilkinson, calm pass. Wilkinson had to dive for it a little bit, but just adding a little bit more drama to it. Calm two goals. Riley Henry playing as a fullback this afternoon. A really great performance and confidence boost for a player that maybe the goals haven't come for her when she's playing up top.